Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
And these are probably going to pick me up and make rackets, so I'm going to get in front of them. I'd like to welcome you to Manfred Waters Community Presbyterian Church. And it's wonderful to see all of you here. I know that you represent a lot of different areas. Some of the communities in the... just raise your hand for a minute and tell us where you're from. Different churches, if you're kind of clusters. Yeah?
St. Rita's in Presque Isle.
St. Rita's in Presque Isle. Okay, others?
Older Junction
Community Church.
Holy Family and Woodruff.
Holy Family from Woodruff.
Our Lady Queen of Peace.
Our Lady Queen of Peace.
St. Isaac Jones in Mercer.
St. Isaac's.
Church of the Pines in Monaco.
Church of the Pines in Monaco.
Community Presbyterian Lac-Flamo.
Lac-Flamo Community Presbyterian.
First English Lutheran
Wausau.
Wow,
Mercer United Methodist. Any others? Going once, going twice. It's wonderful to have you all here. You know, someone went online this morning and told us that there's only two churches, I think it's only two churches in Wisconsin that are celebrating the World Day of Prayer today. And so we're one of them. And at some point during the service, we're going to ask if one of you would be interested in, or in behalf of your church, hosting this next year. In case I forget, where's my Energizer Bunny?
We have a brochure.
No, where's, oh, Carol's back there. She's my 91-year-old that does more than 90% of the people in our church, including me. Anyhow, welcome to the church. My name's Chips. I've been here about 25 years. Chips is my real name. I'm stuck with it, so I use it, and you can feel free to use it as well. And we're going to have a fair amount of stuff that's kind of audiovisual, and it almost guarantees there's going to be problems with it. We'll try and roll with it. There's some African songs that are going to be up there, and at first they're intimidating, but if you listen to them, you can kind of get dragged into the process of being able to sing with them. And it's kind of fun. And on one of them, it's about 10 minutes long, and it took me about 3 hours to get it transliterated and stuff for it phonetically. Basically, the service itself, we're going to be having a series of readings that will be shared by some of our guests behind me. We will be having a little, very brief little skit on the healing of the paralytic in John's Gospel, chapter 5, beginning with verse 1, I think. And several songs. There'll be a time of prayer. What am I forgetting?
Letter from the
Father. Letter from that. Actually, I changed that a little bit. I was going to read it, but I decided I wasn't going to. And I've given it to all of you to read. And it's kind of one sentence at a time. And each of you have a different color-coded badge on you, and that'll correspond to the colors that are up there. And as a group, when those come up on that letter to Zimbabwe, I'd like you to join together and read it as a group in your various parts of the sanctuary. As I was reading it, I felt like it reflected the voices of a lot of people, and I thought that it would be nice to hear that those voices coming from a number of different people. We're going to have snacks afterwards, and you're welcome to join us. We'll be taking an offering. I can't remember where that comes in here. I forgot.
It's worth the
end. Jump up and down, wave your arms if I forget. And that is going to, the proceeds are going to?
World Day of Prayer.
World Day of Prayer. Okay. And my fearless leaders, anything I've forgotten? I'm packing and trying to leave this evening for Honduras. So I'm kind of in my head's in a lot of different places. And also, I've been to Africa several times. I have not been to Zimbabwe, which is the center of the area that we're going to be talking about. I have been to Kenya a number of times, so I figured that it would probably be more appropriate wearing, I messed up my zipper, probably be more appropriate wearing something that fits in Kenyan fare better.
Yes.
So I will do this. I'm also reflecting Guatemala on the stove, where we have a mission trip. Thank you. It's wonderful having you here. This is a lot cooler than the world. And I'm going to have to just keep referring to the bulletin to figure out where we're at. Okay, the first thing we're going to be doing this morning is a song. It's a very simple one, Jesu Tawapano. And we'll be backed up by the African singers on all of these. So just try and sing along with it. And I'll have to be flipping from slide to slide here as we're going. As I said, hopefully it'll work. Didn't take long to mess that. Introduce yourselves and where you're from, and then we can proceed with the prayer. Go ahead.
Martha Krupa, Mercer, Wisconsin. Barbara Meth, Presbyterian Church, Lackawanna.
Sue Claflin, Church of the Pines, Minocqua.
God of peace and freedom, we welcome you in our midst.
We praise you for your love which surpasses all understanding.
We praise you for who you are now and forever.
You are an amazing God.
Creator God, we praise you for the natural resources we are called to care for, like the vegetation, minerals, big animals, waterfalls, and forests of Zimbabwe.
You are a gracious God.
Jesus, we pray you for the gift of respect, the dignity of human life, love for one another, and for the friendliness of the Zimbabwe hardworking people.
You are the bread of life.
Holy Spirit, we praise you for enabling us to gather and worship in Zimbabwe and around the world.
You are the Spirit of Truth who unifies us in prayers and actions.
Now we have an extremely difficult time, and we have to all participate.
Your mic is on.
Pictures, but you'll be able to follow it. I forgot the music too. Were you going to play with this?
Yeah.
Okay, that's fine. Okay, go ahead.
Mm-hmm.
Give thanks, for God is good, for God's steadfast love endures forever. Happy are those who observe justice and do righteousness at all times.
We're going to step away from Africa for a minute. We're going to step into the Hebrew language. This is an old Amy Grant's singing. We're stepping away from Africa for just a moment. We're stepping into Israel. We will be singing an old Amy Grant song called El Shaddai. I think most of you know it, or have heard it. The words up there are as follows. You'll get the hang of it by the end of the song, but El Shaddai, Eliona Adonai, Erkamkana Adonai. Eliona Adonai, Erkamkana Adonai. Hebrew words, in essence, they're God Almighty, Almighty God. That's the gist of what's being said in those. So far, the audiovisual stuff's working very well. The operators is not doing very well. Out of order, jumping all over the place here. This is the letter from, we're going to jump back to the letter from Zimbabwe. And once again, will be doing that according to your colors. Raise your hand if you're red. Yellows, raise your hand. Okay, and whites, raise your hand. Okay, and at the very end, there's a green room. We'll all come in. And don't be shy. Jump in there. If everyone's waiting to hear, if you're too afraid of hearing your own voice, everyone will back up and back up. Pretty soon we'll have a dirge instead of a reading, okay? So just boldly go forward. In fact, maybe I'll read it with through it all so we don't fall into that trap. We start out with friends.
Friends on the path for justice, let us reflect and place our stories before God.
Our people are diverse and have a long history.
From the Great Zimbabwe Empire to today, there are many stories to tell.
We have fought for independence from colonial powers,
then for the formation of a national government led by leaders of the majority of the population. However, we faced political violence during the past national elections.
Efforts to bring all sides into the process of truth and reconciliation are taking longer than most people had thought.
The traumas imposed by the armed conflict are still affecting Zimbabwean society. Since 2017, the country has been going through changes in the government.
Individuals, ecumenical organizations, and churches are actively raising awareness for a peaceful transition.
The 2018 national election saw a great number of young people and first-time voters. And peacefully we went to the polls, even though tensions were still present afterwards.
We continue praying and educating ourselves to be peace builders and to stand for reconciliation in our land.
We recognize that there is unemployment in our communities. We have difficulty providing for our families. Many households in rural areas are headed by women who have nothing to feed their families.
The husbands have moved away to search for jobs in towns and mines,
while the young men and women have migrated to find work in neighboring countries and all over the world. Zimbabweans in the diaspora face a global and anti-migrant sentiment, which makes their lives more difficult.
We hear so many bad things about our country, but we can change this and be proud to be Zimbabweans.
We value our community-based culture and our closely knit families, even though individualism and domestic violence affect our families. Awareness and lobbying for gender equality have increased, and there are laws to protect women against gender-based violence.
Mostly by themselves, women look after children, special needs, and disabilities.
Access to schools for autistic and other special needs children is very limited. On the other side, many families are headed by children who have lost their parents to HIV/AIDS.
There are so many among us who live in need of social assistance.
We anticipate improvement of social services and more opportunities for training, education, and sustainable economic development. We say that in the majority of Zimbabwe, the population is Christian, and we are always praying for the integrity of our churches and our country.
As Christians and women, we want to do more like our predecessors.
They had a strong sense of identification with the needs of women and children. By the grace of God, we are working hard to follow their path. The mouths of the righteous utter wisdom, and their tongues speak justice. Psalm 37:30. And everyone?
And all God's people say, Amen.
Okay. Now, I'll back up one more step and we'll be on target, I think. Let's sing together Jesus Loves Me. And there's a couple verses here, maybe a verse that's not real familiar here.
Come to the pool, come to be made well.
Oh, please help me, please help me.
In the waters of the pool is where healing can be found.
I can't walk, I need help to get to the water. I want to be healed too.
If you wish to be made well, come to the pool.
Do you wish to be made well?
Excuse me?
Do you wish to be made well?
Can you help me? I have not been able to walk most of my life, and I'd really like to get to the water in order to be healed.
Stand, take your mat, and walk.
But you need to understand, I can't walk. I can't walk up there. I need to be healed.
Stand up, take your mat, and walk. Stand, take up your mat, and walk. Your faith has made you well. Take the mat with you as a reminder of the past, and walk boldly forward into the future.
My faith. You have helped me. It's my faith that has done it, not the water. I'm standing on my legs and I can walk. Thank you.
Do you wish to be made well? Then turn your needs over to Christ. Let Christ know your sorrows, your sufferings, griefs, and pains. Let Christ heal you. Let Christ make you well. You have received a card that represents the mats that you hold back from healing, from wholeness, from Christ's gracious mercy. I invite you to take a marker or a pen or pencil And on your card, write down what you want, from what you want to be healed. At the end of the service, stand, take up your mat, and walk into your future, trusting in the Lord.
I'll give you a few moments to write down those things. I'll talk, I guess, as you're writing. The story this morning, Bethsaida, we're not exactly sure where the pool was, but this guy had been going there for 38 years. Apparently, there would be times when the water would get ruffled, and it was conducive to healing at those times. And apparently, the first person into the water would be healed. And this particular guy, woman in this case, had been going to this pool for 38 years. Now, most of the time, beggars, blind people, those types of folks, they had a daily routine that they did each day. If this guy went down to that pool each day, he has made approximately 14,000 days he's been down at that poolside wanting to be healed. And to no avail, he's not able to get to the water, the magical water. I think in each of our lives, we travel to our own Bethsaida. And in our own ways, we kind of wait by the poolside. Each of us have different things that have a way of crippling us, paralyzing us at different times. This particular individual, when you read further in John's Gospel, it said Jesus gives him one final instruction besides take a mat and walk. He talks to him later and he says, don't sin anymore so nothing worse happens to you. So there's some kind of connection with his paralysis and something else going on in his life. But in our lives, all of us have different things that paralyze us. Sometimes it's fear. Sometimes it's an experience from the past. Maybe the loss of a loved one, the loss of a spouse. So it's something that penetrates into the depths of us, and it leaves us kind of paralyzed. It leaves us in a position where we're not able to be the people that God would really want us to be. And as you're thinking about the mat this morning, I'd like you to be thinking about taking whatever that is that's crippled you in the past and give it almost as an offering. You'll be walking out of here with Matt as a reminder, but leave something here as well. Leave the whatever it is that's crippled you here. I'm a member of another organization that has to do with alcohol. I've been sober for 43 years now. But one of the things that I've learned a lot of things across the years from that, one is that an old Catholic priest shared this with me the first time. He said, I don't know a lot about God, he said, but one thing I do know, God's a sucker for gratitude. And so I think that's the beginning, you know, just being grateful. But also across the years, I've learned that a lot of stuff doesn't yield to a frontal attack. A lot of our character shortcomings, a lot of the pains and the fears, the things that have driven us, sometimes a straight ahead attack doesn't deal with them. But I've learned that God can and will lift those things from us when we give them to Him. And so in your prayers this morning, When you leave here, whatever it is that's been kind of haunting you, that's been plaguing you, that's been paralyzing you in different ways, I'd like you to just ask God to take it, lift it from you. Willpower doesn't work. Therapy doesn't, at least for me, a lot of therapy didn't work, but God could and would if I asked for His help. And that's part of what Christ does for us. we get trapped in our own paralyses, in our own wheelchairs, if you will. And his message to us this morning is, or this afternoon, is, hey, take up your mat. Get up, take up your mat, and walk. And may God help all of us to do that. Amen. The next song is one that we are not going to try. Well, some of you can try and sing it if you want. It'll be... It's played, you have the music in front of you. I can't read music, so it was hopeless for me. But you can try and sing along if you so desire. And it'll be up on the... Actually, it won't be up on the screen. The music will be playing in the background and some other things on the screen. It's called Rise, Take Your Mat, and Walk. There'll be some images that are up there, but the text will not be.
Thank you.
Ladies.
Let us experience the empowering energy of the dialogue between the sick man and Jesus. I invite you now to bow your head.
Jesus asks, do you want to be made well?
Yes, yes.
Then Jesus says, rise, pick up your mat and walk.
God is love.
Let us remain standing with our hearts full of love.
By the way, these baskets, after we're done today, they are for sale. They're through the CERB organization, which the profits go back to the developing communities that they were made in. You can talk with Rose, who's on the end over here, if you have interest.
Pastor, to read where some of the money has gone last year. Pastor, would you follow doing the offering?
Okay, these are some of the destinations that the funds were raised last year. The 2019 World Day of Prayer USA grants reflect the wishes of World Day of Prayer Slovenia and the issues concerning women and children. Here's a snapshot of what your 2019 offerings are supporting. Read more at www.wtdpusa.org/grants. World Day of Prayer Slovenia, $1,500. WDP Slovenia plans to hold workshops and seminars focusing on young women, some of them in countries along Slovenia's borders. They will facilitate field work and volunteer opportunities for young women. World Day of Prayer Slovenia workshops for mothers, $1,500. The World Day of Prayer Slovenia will hold preparatory seminars for mothers who do not have babysitters for an entire work. Workshops will promote child service and offer playtime. Association of Evangelical Lutheran Women in Slovenia gets $1,500. They plan on using funds for humanitarian aid projects and to provide women with cultural and historical insight, practical skills through workshops and seminars and aid to people in Prekmurgy. I've never seen the word before, sorry. And then Ursulines in Slovenia operate a cultural and religious center with Montessori kindergarten, space for older students, $1,500 here too. A cultural center and a retreat center the sisters plan to offer and lead women's groups. Chilean Network for Violence Against Women, $4,000. That's in Chile. This organization works to eradicate violence against women and girls. The Lodge They lodge formal complaints, create campaigns, and coordinate public interventions throughout Chile. They developed Beware, the Machismo Mata, a national campaign. And then there's DOC, Rural Development Center, Tamil Nadu, India, $2,775, and they're establishing 5 after-school education centers to educate kids, children of the stone quarry workers. 150 children will be given education, and 20 parents' meetings will be organized. Gurley Network, Uganda, $4,000. This network's mission is to empower all the victims and survivors of gender-based violence through counseling, training, and mentorship, allowing healing and personal development. Their project, Breaking the Silence Together, aims to reduce sexual violence in the Ignaga district and promote a better understanding of sexual violence among women and girls, as well as the community. LEAP, Pakistan, $2,225. LEAP's mission is to transform society through education. LEAP plans to provide educational support to 180 children, ages 4 through 9, in 6 villages over 6 months at preschool centers, enrolling marginalized children and increasing the literacy level of 120 girls. And finally, the Jeremiah Foundation, New York, $2,500. The Jeremiah program provides holistic services designed to empower single mothers to graduate from college and launch a successful career, while also preparing their children for educational and lifelong success. So that's where the funds went last year. And how many of you have been to Africa before? Anyone? A few. I'm guessing that a lot of the funds from this, the offering this year, will be shifted in that direction. One of the things that came up there that struck my memory when I was there, I was going out to Maasai villages, huts, and AIDS and HIV has just run rampant in that area. It's just decimated a lot of the communities. However, when they have the proper medical cocktail, it puts it. I was working with a group of young people last year that were born with HIV. Most of them were born HIV positive, and it became HIV negative with the medications that they were getting, and they were between 20 and 30 years old now, and they were helping other people that are newly diagnosed, but kids with the disease. But the thing that caught my attention when we were doing the reading, there was one family that I visited. I say family because the oldest in the family, I think she was 11 years old, and she was taking care of her 2 younger siblings who were, I don't know, 6 and 4. All of them were on the medications, and this young girl was responsible for it. And it's really important to get the medications every day. If they get off, it's no longer effective and they can't go back to it again. And anyhow, this young girl is being responsible. She's being a parent for these other kids. And you know, we have a lot of poor in our country too. When you go over there, it puts things in a different perspective. Poverty looks different in Africa. Please pray with me. Almighty God, we thank you and praise you for this offering. We ask that you would use it to help those who have great needs. And we ask that you would multiply these gifts and help them to bring the gospel of Jesus Christ, the power of his healing grace, his forgiveness, his great love into the lives of those who these dollars can touch. We thank you for those that cheerfully give, and we ask you to use these gifts now for the work of Jesus in his kingdom. Amen.
Let us join together with the provinces of Zimbabwe and worldwide to give thanks to God. Let us rise and walk in Jesus' unconditional love.
From our corner of the world, we rise and walk.
Please continue to bless us with the gift of life and protection, good rain and fertile soil.
We are caretakers of God's creation.
We lament for our brothers and sisters who had to migrate to other countries. We ask you to protect them and give them good health.
Help us learn to love one another.
We intercede for communities and women who live in fear of violence in families and nations.
Give us wisdom and grace to be peacemakers.
We thank you for the courageous and hardworking pioneer women of the World Day of Prayer in Zimbabwe, who trust our community to pray, love, and forgive.
May we carry on the legacy of courageous women in our communities.
Let us pray together the Lord's Prayer.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
Thank you very much, ladies. Nice job. And we have two final things in this afternoon service. One is a fairly long song, but it's got so much energy and it's fun. I was working on it for a long time trying to put this little thing together, and it's really engaging if you listen to it for a while. It's long. It's about 10 minutes long, so it's we're going to have to ride with it a little bit. You will start getting the hang of the lyrics by the end of it, too.
Sing your love, he's so much.
One thing in Africa too, do you notice there's such vitality and energy in the people and in their singing. And what was being repeated in a lot of different ways is, Jesus, you are the rock. Jesus, you are the rock. One thing I ask of you, let me hide myself in thee. And it's just driven home again and again and again as the passage continues. As a closing activity, we've got Avina. Are you?
Yes.
You want to explain the dance that we're going to see on the screen in a few moments, hopefully?
What you will see next is a character dance choreographed and danced by the Vandre dancers of Iowa, Michigan, of which I am a part. And one of our numbers and ladies wanted a rain stick dance. So what we tried to characterize is not only the people, but these sounds, and later you'll pretend flute, and some of the birds, if you watch, and then you'll see the long arms of the orangutans, and perhaps insects jumping, and the snakes slithering through the trees. And so let your imagination travel to the rainforest. The name of the number is Rainforest Spirit.
Alvina, would you introduce yourself, please?
I'm Alvina Kuzmeri. I live in this town, but I go to the United Methodist Church in Mercer. That's where I come from.
I had this up here when we started. No. We may get a little bit of a ballet dance before the rain dance. Kind of hurt it. Okay, sneak it ahead a little bit. Any ballerinas in our midst?
Thank you.
all for coming today, and I hope you've been blessed by the gathering we've had together. There's some refreshments immediately following our service, and we invite you to please join us there. Now may the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious to you. May the Lord lift up the light of his countenance upon you and grant you his peace, both now and forevermore. Amen.
Amen.